Hey, what's up everyone? This is Luke, and welcome back to our beginning core data video series. In this video, we'll look at relationships, how to model relationships between entities, and how to link the model objects together via code. This time, you'll be taking a look at some bow tie management software. This is what the app will look like by the end of the demo. You'll be able to assign an owner to each bow tie, establishing a relationship between the two objects. Relationships allow you to relate objects to other objects in a structured and well-defined way. For example, say you have your classic person entity, and you also want to throw bow ties into the mix. You can set up a relationship named owner that you would use to assign a user object to be the bow tie's owner. If your app is set up so that each user is only allowed to own one bow tie at a time, then this relationship would be what's known as a one-to-one mapping. In your code, if you have access to the bowtie object, you would be able to access the associated person object via the owner property. Most relationships have an inverse, which lets you think of the relationship in the other direction. In this example, say you have a person object and you want to see which bowtie they own. You would need to set up another relationship, maybe called owned bowtie, that allows you to get to the bowtie through the associated user. In order for the new owned bowtie relationship to affect the owner property of the bowtie, you'd need to set the two relationships to be each other's inverses. This is very important to do since it ensures that your object graph stays consistent. Another possible case is that your application allows people to own more than one bowtie. This is what's known as a one-to-many relationship. Each bowtie could still only have one owner, but the user object's relationship would be renamed to something like owned bowties and would consist of a set of all bowties that have that particular person object as their owner. All right, here we are in the bowtie management app. First, let's take a look at what we've got so far. It looks like we've got an app where you can choose to look at any of seven bowties and see the stats for each one. As you can see, this is a red bowtie. It's got a rating of 3.5 out of 5, it's been worn 4 times, and it was last worn on this date. We also have this owner button feature. As you can see right now, it's just an empty table. Our goal this time is to get people set up in the app so that they can become the owners of these bow ties. Let's hop over to the data model editor and get started. The first thing we need to do is add the user entity to our data model. Users are pretty simple. The only attribute they'll have is a name, and it'll be of type string. Now that we have our user set up, we'll need to add a relationship to connect users and bow ties. Adding a relationship is just as easy as adding an attribute. All you need to do is come down to the relationship section and hit the plus button. In this case, we want to allow users to own as many bow ties as they want. That means we'll need a too-many relationship called bow ties. The destination is the bowtie entity. For now, we can't set the inverse, but we will in a little bit. Sometimes Xcode can be a little weird about what it shows in the data model inspector to the right, so if you don't see what you're looking for over here, you can click on the entity and then click back on the relationship, and then it'll change to what it needs to be. Now that we got that working, we can change our type to a too-many relationship. And then we can also make this relationship non-optional. Since too many relationships are represented as a set, we can just use an empty set instead of a nil value here. Next, we need to add an inverse relationship to the bowtie entity so that we can think about the relationship in both directions. Since bowties can only be owned by one person at a time, we'll just call this relationship owner. The destination will be users. And now we can set up the inverse to be bowties. Doing this automatically sets the bowtie relationship to have an inverse of owner. All right, before we regenerate our managed object subclasses, there's one more thing we need to do. If we look at user again, we'll see that our module isn't set up and our code gen is set to class definition. Bowties are set to the current product module and manual none. That's what we're going to want for users as well. All right, and now we're ready to generate our subclasses. And here we have our new user managed object. One thing to keep in mind is that the generators that generate our managed object subclasses actually ignore the optionality settings we choose. So here we can just come in and delete this question mark and make it non-optional. Other than that, our managed object subclasses are ready to go. Now we can go to usersviewcontroller.swift and get our user table set up. Here we're going to use a fetched results controller to display all of the users in the table. Then, when a user is selected, they'll become the owner of whatever the current bow tie is. Most of the commented out code here should be pretty familiar to you if you've seen the previous videos about fetched results controllers. If not, I encourage you to go back and watch them, but if so, we can go ahead and uncomment this to get our basic table set up. Here we have our fetched results controller. And then in view.load, we'll actually set it up and use it. And before I forget, I should uncomment the code in insert sample data. This method just grabs some sample data from a local plist. And then we have our table view data source methods. Here we create a simple cell. And then here we just return the number of sections and number of rows in each section. Let's go ahead and build and run and check out our table. All right, we successfully have a table filled with some users. The last thing we need to do is set this table up so that anytime a user is selected, they'll become the owner of the current bow tie. To do that, we'll add a delegate protocol that will notify the main view controller anytime a user is selected. All right, we have a simple delegate that just has one method called didAssignUser. We'll just call that when the user is tapped. Next, we need to set up our delegate property. And then we can just call didAssignUser in didSelectRowAtIndexPath. Here we just grab the appropriate user object from our fetched results controller, and then pass it back to the delegate using the didAssignUser method. Once we've done that, we can just pop back to the main view controller. Next, we need to go ahead and have view controller conform to this delegate protocol. We can just add a new extension above our color extension. Here we can just grab the current bow tie and set its owner property to be the user. As you can see, using a relationship is just like using any other normal property. We can just set the user that's passed in to the owner property of current bow tie. Since we set up the inverse relationship, this will automatically update the user's list of owned bow ties. Now that we have our delegate method set up, we need to go ahead and set ourselves to be the delegate in the prepare for segue method. And then the final thing we need to do is make sure that our owner button always has the correct title. Here we have the name hard-coded to none, but instead we want to check and see if there is an owner, and if so, use their name. All right, now that we got that all set up, let's go ahead and build and run. Here we can come in and select a user. And then when it transitions back, we can see that the owner is successfully set to Greg.
After two objects have been associated with a relationship, there are a few ways you can have one object react to the other one being deleted. Each relationship has its own delete rule attached, which can be changed in the model editor. There are four possible delete rules, and by default, the nullify option is chosen. If you delete person, all bow ties who had that person as their owner get their owner property set to nil. The second option is deny. This means you can't delete a record if it has any other objects associated with it. The third option is cascade. This option means deleting an object will also delete all the objects it has a relationship with. For example, if one person owned all the bow ties and then was deleted, every bow tie would get deleted right along with them. The fourth and final option is no action. If, as the name suggests, this will do nothing, which means it's your job to clean things up. If you delete a bow tie and forget to fix any person object that claims to own that bow tie, you may run into trouble later with a dangling reference. That's it for this video tutorial, and as always, we like to leave you with a challenge. Your challenge this time is to take what you just learned about delete rules and add the ability to delete users from the app. I hope you've enjoyed this video tutorial. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.